those who want to get rich fall into temptation and a snare and many foolish and harmful desires, which plunge men into ruin and destruction. For the love of money is a root of all sorts of evil, and some by longing for it have wandered away from the faith and pierced themselves with many griefs. Those who want to get rich. You know, in the parable of the sower and the seed, Jesus warned us. This is Matthew 13:22. He said, "And the one on whom seed was sown among the thorns, this is the man who hears the word, and the worry of the world and the deceitfulness of riches choke the word, and it becomes unfruitful." The deceitfulness of riches is nothing more than that lying devil who is worshipped in the world as mammon. A lot of people don't get that, right? Speaking to you, trying to seduce you from the path of righteousness. His desire is written for us to see. Satan comes to steal, to kill, and destroy. John 10:10. You know, I've shared this with Mark before. Alice and I had the occasion, we knew a lot of wealthy Christians when I had started a couple of Christian businesses. And we had occasion to meet with half dozen guys for a lunch meeting in Sarasota, Florida at the country club. And one of the fellows is, really, really well known. He's written quite a number of books on Christians and finances. He's a brilliant guy when it comes to Christians and finances. He's done consulting with churches all over the United States. So he was sitting next to me and Alice, and we were having lunch. And in the conversation, he said, "Money talks," or "the world says money talks." Mm-hmm. That's what he said. "The world says money talks." I said, "I know. Jesus said the same thing." Well, that stopped the conversation around the table for a minute. And people said, "What do you mean that Jesus said that money talks?" I said, "He did. He said that it talks. He just said that it lies."
That's right.
"Beware the deceitfulness of riches." I'm going to tell you what, you put money in front of people, it says it'll start
lies,
screaming at most
lies,
of them.
Lies.
And it'll tell you.
Bet you that was a forehead slapping moment.
Well, it is, because but
you just went pow.
It's so true. Money talks, but it lies, because it's going to promise you all the things that it can do for you. Mm-hmm. It's going to promise how it can take care of you. You know, in the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus said, "No man can serve God and mammon." The truth is, money will never serve you. When you have that greed, you'll be serving the money all the time. You'll be a slave to it. So we need to understand that, because everything in the world around us is focused on making us believe that money is the answer to every situation, every problem, every human condition that's wrong. Money can fix it. It cannot. You know, this topic is so important, because when it comes to greed, covetousness, as Paul wrote in his letter to the Colossians, it's idolatry. That's what it is. Greed is idolatry. Silver and gold. Remember Peter and John going up the steps of to the temple? And the beggar was there. And Peter said to him, "Silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, I give you." Peter had something far better than silver and gold. And he touched that man's life. God used him to touch that man's life in a life-changing way that money never could have done. Never could have done. We're so focused on money. Fix your eyes on Jesus Christ, the author, the finisher, the perfecter of your faith, and you will find out what true happiness, true contentment is and where it comes from. Do not love the world or the things of the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the boastful pride of life is not from the Father, but is from the world. 1 John 2:15-16. We live in a world, and I've said this a number of times in this study, we live in a world where it is filled with propaganda. Every time you turn on a radio, every time you turn on a television, every time you drive down the street and see a billboard, that is propaganda trying to incite you to desire. To desire that new car, to desire that, it's all about that, trying to stir that up in you. I mean, this has been around a long time. Remember, Jesus in the wilderness mm-hmm. was tempted by the devil.
Yes, he was.
Who was trying to tell him, you know, you can have all of this, or you can have all this, all these glories of the world. You can have that. Just bow down to me. And but I didn't say it becomes a god. When you think that money is the answer to your problems, you have forgotten what the psalm says, from whence cometh my help? My help cometh from the Lord. Okay? He is your Savior. He is the one that can fix your problem. He is the one that can heal your soul. He is the one that can do all the things that you need.
Faithful God, so unchanging. You're my rock of peace, Lord of all.